And it gives me immense pleasure to be here at the Litto Fest, London.
Idea 5 years back, I took it up as a responsibility and we started hosting Litto Fest as a bridge between these aspiring talent of the country across the globe. Also, in fact, we get manuscripts from all across the globe and we publish them totally for free.
London chapter, I was really impressed because it was, first of all, it was being conducted in a place like London. We have so many things in common. India and London have so many things in common. And that really binds us together. And secondly, the cause. Smitaji aims to have one village on board which she can equip with education. And when we talk of literature, it shouldn't be confined to only a few countries or a few people. It should be there to understand, to be read and understood by each one of us. And so the ignorance of education cannot be a reason for not being educated. So I'm thankful to you for trying to bridge this gap. And it's a noble endeavor where in Shahpur you are giving them from books to bicycles, everything which
Mumbai
can equip them.
They now come to London and it's ever growing. In fact, Litto Fest is a platform which takes pride in glorifying literature, art, culture and music. It is an honor to see Litto Fest being organized in London. In our dreams also we couldn't think about that, but thanks to Smita, she's been striving to do that. In fact, Litto Fest provides a platform for both the aspirants, the people emerging, and of course, the award-winning talent in the field of literature, art and culture, to present and share the knowledge about their expertise through discussions, contests, and London Litto Fest has just started. I'm sure I must say that, Smita, I know every beginning is a hard beginning, but this is just the first baby step. This is a long way to go, where cultures meet together. People, I think art, culture doesn't have any language, doesn't have any boundaries.
I think Litto Fest is bringing and doing a great service, and they are taking it to support the sustainability development goals set up by United Nations, promoting inclusivity, bridging the gap of inequality. So they are taking it to the rural areas.
So yahan literature festival jo hai wo ab literature tak nahi reh gaya. Ye Litto Fest ने बहुत व्यापक स्थान ले लिया है, बहुत बड़ा स्थान ले लिया है. इसके माध्यम से सेवाएं शुरू हो गई. अभी जैसे सुना, लोग इंस्पायर होते हैं. गुजरात में भी एक गांव अडॉप्ट कर लिया गया, हमने महाराष्ट्र में किया.
Litto Fest and tourism, now we have collaborated these two things. So apart from literature, culture and now tourism. So how do you see Litto Fest traveling all across the globe with the tourism enhancing with this?
I must say Litto Fest is on a great mission. And the mission is worthwhile mentioning because it is going to collaborate for causes like reducing the ignorance and bringing it towards literacy. So I thank you for this. And today we have a lot to explore in Maharashtra. Similarly, Literature Fest has so much to explore across the world. In fact, London chapter is the best beginning which could have happened with so many people, with the blessings of so many people, especially MTDC and Rawal sir, Vijay sir, and you being there as a backbone to it, I'm sure it's going to go places. But the main aim or the ambition behind it should be uniting people, should be taking care of the people, marginalized people, should be giving great quality literature to the world. And I hope you keep up with this tradition forever, and the sky is the limit for you, and let us all enjoy this beautiful endeavor from today.
Maharashtra actually is blessed with a lot of things. If you look at Maharashtra geographically, on one side you have Mumbai, and from Mumbai to Goa, the very famous Mumbai to Goa picture was there. But from Mumbai to Goa, the whole shoreline is Maharashtra. We have a 720 kilometer shoreline, and right from Mumbai to Goa. And before entering Goa, you have a beautiful district called the Sindhudurg district, which is straight. So there are around 36 forts in Sindhudurg district, very small district, and there are numerous beaches. So you can, what you see in different parts of the world, because I've also traveled a bit, but you all must have traveled. We look at the silver beaches, which are white in color. Sometimes we look at the golden beach, which are brown in color. So in one district, we have all these beaches. We have the green water, the blue water. We have scuba diving. So in Sindhudurg and Raigad, which are the seashore districts, which we call the sea, sun, shore, that kind of tourism, dolphins we can spot 24/7, 365.
Research की बात हो रही थी कि सबसे पहले तो ये पता लगाना पड़ता है कि किसको हम adopt करें, कौन सा विलेज है जिसको सबसे ज़्यादा ज़रूरत है, क्योंकि जो developed villages हैं, कि और भी लोग तो कर रहे हैं, सदर की सिर्फ हम ही लोग कर रहे हैं ये काम, और भी लोग हैं जो विलेज अडॉप्ट करते हैं और उसको डेवलप करते हैं, हेल्प करते हैं. तो पहले तो हमको ये पता लगाना होता है कि ऐसा कौन सा विलेज है जिसको बहुत जल्दी ज़रूरत है, जहाँ लोगों को काफ़ी तकलीफें हैं. तो वो पता लगाने के बाद हम लोग वहाँ पहुँचते हैं, काम करते हैं, एक टीम लेके जाते हैं, उसको थोड़ा समझते हैं, और उसके बाद जिन जिन चीज़ों की वहाँ ज़रूरत है उसको हम भेजते हैं. विलेज अडॉप्ट करना इसलिए ज़रूरी है कि हमारा जो भारत है वो विलेजेस में रहता है, हमारा भारत शहरों में नहीं रहता. 80% ऑफ आवर पॉपुलेशन इज लिविंग इन विलेजेस, 80%. तो सबसे ज़्यादा अगर भारत के,
आई ऑलवेज ट्राई टू बी द बेटर वर्जन ऑफ माई यस्टरडे. या आई ट्राई टू स्ट्राइक अ बैलेंस बिटवीन द कॉन्टेंट एंड स्टाइल, कथे और शिल्प, एंड ऑल्सो my practice of not taking myself very seriously. Whatever we write are not religious documents. We should have the courage to laugh at our work and move on and write better again.
Yeah.
So that helps us grow, I feel.